letting me speak to you here tonight. So I've talked to a few of you regarding the water billing policy that municipalities have been enforcing all across the province. With this policy, I've contacted the Brantford City of Brantford so that I can figure out if they have it in place or if they're going to have it in place. Right now, after speaking with the city today, she was advising me that there is some delinquent utilities from tenants that are being put onto landlords' property taxes. So I don't know how they can do some and not all. So I have the manager from the water department going to be calling me, so I will have like the full detail of what's happening and what we can expect for Brantford and if they are responsible for delinquent utilities from their tenants. In Cambridge, the city has changed the policy numerous of times from a six-step collection process down to a five-step collection process. Tenants in Cambridge are paying $230 for a deposit for their water, which is extremely high since they do have to pay for deposits for hydro, gas, and their first and last month's rent, and now water. So this is why it's not just the landlord's issue, because landlords are seeing $1,500 water bills in Cambridge. Tenants are being evicted out of their units because of non-payment of a utility. It's either through the board or it is through small claims court. It's very new, so they don't know who's actually handling this. At the same time, I'm actually supporting landlords one way or another because this water billing issue is just a stepping stool of what the province can have in store for landlords and what you're going to be responsible for. And that's why we're protecting tenants at the same time, because if hard times fall on the tenants, more hard times are going to fall underneath the landlord because they make it impossible for the tenants to actually have affordable housing, now unable to have affordable utilities at the same time. So right now with the city of Cambridge, they used to have a final meter. They used to transfer accounts. Now they don't. So it's every time you move, there's a $25 setup account fee, a $50 final meter fee. Then if they charge tenants $4 tacked onto their account every single month, I've been harassing them, so they dropped it down to $2 because I'm concerned of the fees that tenants are being charged because it will be put to the property taxes if they make it unfeasible for that tenant to pay. Landlords in Cambridge used to be responsible for the $300 for the removal of the meter when a tenant does get shut off, and now they're saying that tenants are responsible for it. And tenants are also responsible for $100, that it's a 7-day cutoff. That is $100 because you got that 7-day notice, and then when you get cut off, you get another $300. So that's $400 right there that a tenant's responsible for, but it will go to the property owner if they do come in that they're not going to pay it. And it is extremely high since they do have many months of consumption. I've been in Oshawa. We've been discussing this with landlords up there with the Peterborough Landlords Association. They're in transitioning right now. They used to be flat rate fees for their water. Now they're actually going to be doing it where it's the same system in Cambridge. You know, it's the meter reading. And when they do this, they're making landlords have no other choice but make it mandatory that they have to have the water bill in their name and not the tenant's name. And obviously, we see a lot of rippling effects from it. Now, landlords are open to abusive tenants. They are constantly going to be having to knock on the tenant's door, and the property managers are going to be having to go and knock on the doors as wherever it may be and be a debt collector for the city. Even though for Cambridge, after Hydro had this water, had the water bill and they wanted double the amount, they were responsible for it and they were well equipped to do it. Landlords are not. We are not no collection agency. We don't know really how to approach people. We do have the slumlords that people do talk about, and you don't know how they will handle a situation like that. And this is why it's such an extreme importance that we stop sitting back and taking these rules that are being passed down to landlords. And it's glad that you are a part of this organization, because more landlords need to be part of an organization so that it's not hard for me to give the information out to landlords. I don't have to hunt them down and put my ad on Kijiji and call them on the phone and let them know what's happening. So, and now it's, landlords are scared. They're scared of what's happening with the water billing. They're scared of what could happen with gas, because technically if the city owns the gas company, they could make landlords responsible for the gas, delinquent gas bills that a tenant has as well. And now what are landlords doing? They have to do everything they possibly can to protect themselves, which is not very much. You could put something in the lease, but everyone knows that, you know, water is a human right, and we want to make sure that it stays that way, where no one should be shut off for a non-payment of a utility, and no one should be kicked out of their house for a non-payment of a utility. So now it's up to you. How do you pick your tenants? Like many landlords have been telling me that they're picking a two tenants rather than a family of five to move into their building, because it's going to be that, okay, a family of five's water bill compared to a family of two water bill. That's how they're gonna kind of balance who they actually take. And then they look at people who, you know, you turn away people due to a higher risk because they are not paying their rent. Well, now you have to, you know, step that notch up a bit, because now are they capable of paying their utility bills at the same time? Landlords are one of the small-scale landlords are the major ones affected by this. I mean, we're like 40% dealing with the affordable housing here. We make it feasible for tenants to, you know, live cheap, you know, help them out so that they can be homeowners. They don't want to be tenants for the rest of their life. We need to make it easy for them to buy houses. And now landlords are either pushed into selling their property or going bankrupt. The senior landlords are having a major problem with this, because one, I find that in my opinion, I believe that most tenants, they do disrespect the senior landlords, thinking, oh, you get your money when I want, that's it, because they don't see the pressure that most other landlords put on the tenant. So I come to you for the support, for whatever you can do, spread the word, contact your real estate associations, your real estate board, contact your MPP, call your counselors of your city. And because I bet you they are thinking about it for sure, because if there is some kind of transitioning happening in your city, and it will be put onto you, and it could be, you know, maybe you do want a property. Maybe you want a property that, you know, right now you have all inclusive, but maybe you do want something that's a great value, but due to this non-payment of a utility put onto your property taxes, is it really worth it now? And this is why it's turning away investors from Ontario. Ontario is ours already, you know, not the greatest place to invest in, and everyone knows about the board and how long it takes to kick someone out of your unit. So they could be living in your unit for months and months and months, and the water still stays flowing. $1,500 water bill in Cambridge, and that water is still flowing. So it's a balance of, you have to stand up, you have to start voicing your concerns with as many people as you possibly can, because they know landlords are quiet. They know we're not gonna, you know, start ranting and raving like some tenants do with signs and protesting their slumlords. This is how they got those rules in. 91% of the rental applications actually come from landlords. So you know how this act is.